Hi, my name is Blake Schnebly, and I am the camp director for Ted Trueblood's Trout Camp, which we host out of Boise, Idaho every summer. And I'm just kind of here today to give you a little rundown about what the goals of our camp are and what we do and how we break each day down to make it kind of an amazing experience for the volunteers and the campers that get to join us. On Monday, the new campers and the younger campers spend the day at MK Nature Center learning about all of the different displays at MK Nature Center and what a native plant and a native animal is and all of our different native fishes in Idaho. And the older campers who have been to camp several times before get to head up to River Camp at Barber Flat Cabin in the Idaho City Ranger District, and they get to actually set up the tents, set up the camp, and go fishing for an extra day because ideally they've already been told all the information that they need to be successful anglers and successful stewards of our rivers in the future. MK Nature Center, we start out with a safety talk and introductions, and everyone gets to know each other. We go through knots and the different pieces of a fly rod. We move on and we get a little introduction to the grounds, and we get to see all the different displays and learn about all the different interactions from the tanks and the fish. They learn to cast the fly rod. We size them for boots, and then we go into kind of the habitat, and they learn all the native fishes. They learn ecosystems and ecology. Historically, we try to then take them on class in the creek where they can go through entomology and get their feet wet, quite literally, and be familiar with being in a moving body of water and be comfortable with the current pushing them around a little bit. This year, we got to do class in the creek up at fishing camp instead of down in the town in Boise because the river was too high. But we did do a pretty awesome slip and slide activity, which of course correlated to them beginning to understand kind of the barriers to spawning of our native trout as we begin to interact with these river systems and culvertize them and channelize them and affect the different mobility and migrations of fish as they try to find their spawning grounds. So on day two, we've already got our older kids up at River Camp, and the younger kids meet back at MK Nature Center and load into a huge school bus, at which point we bus way up to Barber Flat Cabin and are greeted by lunch and a pretty excited group of volunteers who are ready to take us fishing. We spend the whole afternoon on Tuesday, the second day, fishing, and then we come back, we finish whatever activity we're doing. This year it was lanyards and class in the creek, and we got to do seine netting and entomology, and we came back and broke into groups, and the interested students got to tie flies or at least examine the collections relative to fly tying, and those that were ready to go catch a few more fish got to fish the evening catch. Then we would get to wake up on Wednesday and we're all back together. It's the third day of camp and people are starting to kind of understand the schedule. First thing we do is breakfast, and then we hit the river. Ideally, we can get a bunch of fish in the morning. This year it was kind of a bit slower than I've been used to for the morning fishing, but we all had a pretty good time. And meet back for lunch at camp, and then students get to go swimming or fishing in the afternoon. Our swimmers had a pretty good time. We learned how to deal with currents, how to read rapids, the best way if you fall in to protect your body and get into shallow water and stand back up. And we did a lot of swimming in cold water while it was really, really warm outside. So it was a nice change for everyone that couldn't quite focus on fishing 12 hours a day. After swimming, we meet back at camp. We generally have an activity, and this year on Wednesday, we did a casting competition, which was really quite cool. We split into two groups, the younger campers and the older campers, and it was a pretty fierce competition between all of the different age groups, but two sisters actually won it in both groups, which was kind of a cool thing to see. Friday morning is a little bit tough. It's the last day of camp, and we've all been fishing and having a great time all week long, and it's a little bit of a push, but we get packed up, we get our tents packed up, we do one final session for fishing, and sometimes we even get to catch some fish. So this is the 10th successful trout camp that we've had at Ted Trueblood here out of Boise, Idaho. And we're pretty excited to be going and already planning for our 11th. I would highly recommend, if trout camp is something that interests you, to go ahead and Google trout camp near you. During any given summer, there are 25 or 26 different camps operating throughout the US, and they're a great way to learn how to fish and learn about fisheries and increase your interest in all things trout.
What's your favorite part about trout camp?
My favorite part about trout camp was probably how we got to catch fish on our own.
My favorite part about trout camp is catching fish and seeing new people and doing stuff with them.
Oh, my favorite part about trout camp is learning how to fish. When I came here, I didn't know that well. Yeah. Know that much about fishing. It's super fun.
Yeah. I'm with Sean. I didn't really know about, I never knew how to use a fly rod, and now I'm a lot. Like, it's so much fun at trout camp. I love meeting new people and everything. Catching fish, it's the best year.
Okay. My favorite part was the fishing.
Is the delicious food and fishing, sometimes, because it gets too cold, but whatever.
My favorite part about trout camp is fishing and learning how to cast and not go too far.
Perfect.
1 second, I'm about to sneeze.
Just sneeze.